radio for a car made from scrap material and junk box materials. Of course, it doesn't look nice, but it works. And that's always my aim in my videos, to show some circuits, electronic circuits that work, really work. This is an old FM stick, radio stick. And here you can see that you can scan, reset, etc. And this radio stick, it's the FM radio here, is connected to the end amplifier, and that's here. There is a video on my channel where I publish this end amplifier chip. I don't know exactly the name of the video, but perhaps I will publish that later in the text box. Here are all the outputs and the inputs. One important issue in this circuit is that the loudspeakers here are not connected to the general ground. The general ground, that's the chassis from your car, and also the minus from the car battery is always connected to the chassis here. So that's more or less always the case. But in this case here, the two minus connections from the loudspeakers are not connected to the general ground. But of course, the end amplifier is connected to the general ground. This is the FM stick. You can take out the radio signal on an FM stick always at the volume potentiometer. So that's why I've drawn here the volume potentiometer, 100 nanofarad capacitor to separate it in a DC sense. And from the FM stick you can send the radio signal into the end amplifier. And here I've made a switch where I can switch between this part of the circuit. It's a Kinch input, but you can also use, for instance, these devices. Here you see that you can connect a cable here, and then put the signal into the end amplifier, left, right, etc. So this part of the circuit is stereo, and here it's mono. Here are the two volume potentiometers in the input. They both are 33 kilo-ohms, and here's the input capacitor to separate it all from DC current. Want to show that again. Here you see these two capacitors, the blue ones. Both are input capacitors to the end amplifier chip. And this amplifier chip is also quite sensitive. So you don't need a preamplifier. Do some panning again. Input from a stick, input from the FM stick. Here I made a voltage divider to supply the FM stick with 3 volts. Originally it was made to work on two 1.5 volt batteries or 1.2 volt nickel cadmium batteries. This is the voltage divider. Here is a 1000 farad microfarad capacitor to keep the whole circuit away from motor boating sounds. stabilizes somewhat, and here is 3 volts present. Always use a fuse when you connect something to a car battery. A car battery can deliver a lot of energy, far too much to handle 100 ampere or so. This is always necessary, a fuse. The car battery is connected here in the minus wiring to the general ground. So time for some demonstration. I put on now the circuit. Scan. Put up the volume. So this is the radio part. Here we have the antenna, this wire, this is the antenna. It goes to the antenna from the car, and I've mounted here a 15 picofarad capacitor. I don't know exactly how this all will function in reality, so perhaps I have to connect this wiring from the antenna directly to the antenna on the car. But it could be possible that I need a 15 picofarad capacitor to prevent, let's say, distortion and too strong FM radio signals.
In het volgende uur hier wordt dat vastgesteld. Ik stel een vraag over vandaag. Jij belt met het antwoord. Heb je het goed? Dan mag jij straks het staatsexamen afleggen. De vraag is, wie hoor je hier?